What a beautiful day it is today. The sun is shining, the birds are tweeting. You know, without genetic diversity, we wouldn't have all of this beautiful scenery. What is genetic diversity, you ask? Genetic diversity is the whole reason behind why this will kill you and this won't. It determines an organism's physical and behavioral traits, helps it survive in its current climate, reduces the negative effects of homozygosity, and helps it adapt for future climates. Is that too dense? Let me break it down. Let's start with genetics, shall we? Now there is a reason why this doesn't look like this. It's because of their genotypes and phenotypes. Genotypes are the genetic codes of an organism, all of the information stored in their DNA. They regulate your height, your hair color, and eye color, as well as your behavioral traits, such as how stubborn you are and how long you take to stop procrastinating on your homework. Your phenotypes are how your genotypes are expressed. Have you ever heard of that little fun fact about how you share 50% of your DNA with a banana? Well, your phenotypes are why you don't look like half a banana right now. Genetic diversity also helps organisms adapt to their current environment. Let's take the cactus for example. Its stems store water and its root systems can spread far and wide to collect water from underground. Their spikes minimize surface area and therefore minimize water loss, as well as protect them from predators. Genetic diversity reduces the negative effects of little genetic variation. Genetic variation, or its lack of, can affect a species' survival. When both copies of genes are identical, it can lead to little tolerance of a certain environmental characteristic. This may tie into its ability to cope with the environment. Here's an example. This is the gross Michael banana, also known as Big Mac. It was the prime banana species of its time. It was exported all over North America and Europe. That is, until the year of 1965. By then, the Panama disease, a wilt caused by the fungus Fusarium oxysporum, was given rise and wiped out plantations all over. Big Mike was considered commercially dead. The banana industry was in crisis and had to look for alternatives. They decided upon the Cavendish species, for it was immune to disease. A thing you should know about Cavendish bananas, however, they have little genetic variability, a monoculture per se. They were all clones of each other, which is why they are under threat today by a new strain of Panama disease. In 50 years' time, the bananas as we know it may go extinct again. Finally, only genetic diversity will be able to help organisms adapt to the future environment. No organism can predict the future, nor can any be adapted for all environments. Nonetheless, the current genetic composition will be able to tell how well an organism is able to adapt. Let's say a certain species has lived in a cool, wet environment for generations, and suddenly the climate changes to warm and dry. In populations with many alleles, those species may persist because some individuals will be able to survive with a possible heat-resistant trait. Others may not and fail to reproduce. The Florida yew is one of the rarest conifers in North America. However, when climate conditions were cooler and wetter, it must have been widespread. For reasons unknown, it failed to move northward. It now resides in remote locations in the Apalachicola River Basin in southern Georgia and in the Florida Panhandle. Without genetic diversity, all plants and animals will be the same and soon die off. All of our native species are important, so please do be careful with our environment. Thank you.